In fact, Teddy and I both felt that Dupree had won the first three rounds, but things started to turn a little bit in round number four. That's where we'll pick up the action from Chattanooga, Tennessee. In round number four, remember, 10 rounds for women's championship boxing at stake, the featherweight championship, two-minute round. Bob Papa along with Teddy Atlas from Chattanooga, and again, Dufoe and Nichols mix it up to start the round. Teddy, how do you see it scored through the first three?
So I have a 29-28 for Dufoe. The last round very close.
I agree with you. And this entire fight basically has been fought in very close quarters.
And again, Nichols would want to fight on the outside. Obviously, just doesn't know how to. But she has the physical advantages to do that better than Dufoe, and take advantage of Dufoe being short and maybe a little stronger.
You look at some punch numbers through three rounds, and you see that Dufoe has landed more punches. She's at 50%. A little bit better job.
But obviously she's not. See how far away Dufoe is? By the time she gets started, she gives her opponent, Nichols, time to counter. Only problem is Nichols is not throwing the punches at the right time. That time she did. Nice straight right hand.
Man, she timed it nicely.
Again, the shortcomings on these girls would be their defense. Because you can take a kid off to speed, Bob, and they're going to go in that ring, maybe only for a few seconds, but they're going to throw punches. But getting away from the punches, that's a science. And these girls happen to have a real lot of experience. They're doing pretty good considering, but that's their only shortcoming on them. They got plenty of heart, and offensively, they're not bad.
Good chance by Nichols, kept Dufoe away.
100.
Again, with Dufoe starting to fall away right now, Nichols should be able to meet her with a punch.
Nichols using the jab a little bit. And Dufoe comes flying in. Boy, they just continue to go at it as round four ends.